Hey there guys, it's Chris here, founder and CEO of Trademasters. So I received a lot of requests from our subscribers asking why Nifty was so bullish during this budget 2021 and a lot of questions regarding how exactly you need to trade during these periods. So I decided to make a small video explaining the Nifty's movement during budget 2021, why it was so bullish, and I've included a small notes on some rules that you need to follow for each and every day that you take. So let's get started with the rules, and after that we'll look into the Nifty chart. So there are four basic rules that you need to understand before taking any trade. Okay, so the first and important rule is go with the trend. Never go against the trend. Don't even think about going against the trend, especially during news days. And the second rule is technical analysis always work in whatever market it is, in bullish market, bearish market, if there is a news in particular stock or something, technical analysis always work. Market will always give an indication before moving in a particular direction. You need to properly analyze the stock or market sentiments, and you need to properly understand the contents behind it, and you need to use proper technical analysis before taking an entry, before taking each trade, an entry in each trade. And the third one is always have an open-minded market. Okay, so we'll get back to this third point. I'll give an example for this third point when you are analyzing the Nifty chart. And the fourth one, use strict stop loss and trail with trailing stop loss. So this is the most important rule among all the four. So never take a trade or never trade in stock market without stop loss. Stop loss is like a god in market. Okay, it basically preserves your capital if the prediction is going against your wish. So never take a trade without a stop loss. I've seen a huge number of traders that have made huge losses, like losses in sense like 5 lakh, 10 lakh in a single trade because they neglected to use a stop loss. Okay, so make this as a thumb rule: never trade without a stop loss. And the next one, trailing stop loss. So trailing stop loss in the sense like this is especially for retail traders, because retail traders mostly don't know where exactly the market is going to end. They'll be predicting like, okay, it's an uptrend, but where exactly do you set up your target? If you don't know the target, and in order to maximize your loss, what I would suggest you guys to do is use a trailing stop loss. If the market has moved by 50 points, move your trailing stop loss by 30 points. Keep on trailing your profits. Okay, and when the market finally reverses, book your profit and come out. So that is the major importance of trailing stop loss, and trailing stop loss plays a very major important role during news. I'll give an example for trailing stop loss as well when we look into the Nifty chart. Okay, so this is just a brief about the rules that you need to follow before each and every single trade that you take. So let's have a look at the Nifty chart. So this is my Nifty chart, and if you see the previous history from the fall, from the crash in March 2000, from the crash in March 2020, Nifty is in a complete uptrend. You can see it's making completely new higher highs, higher high. And recently on Friday, Nifty reached all the way up to 15,000. Okay, so let's just ignore this part and we'll just concentrate on what exactly happened to Nifty during budget day. Okay, so our initial prediction on Nifty was that it will be forming a head and shoulder pattern. So this is a head and shoulder pattern. I've already drawn it. So our prediction on Nifty was that it will be forming a head and shoulder pattern, and once a pattern low is broken out, Nifty will fall all the way down to 13,600. So that was the initial prediction. But Nifty did not form a head and shoulder pattern. It took a triple bottom and it broke the triple bottom and it went all the way down to 13,600. So this is your first bottom and this is your second bottom and this is your third bottom. Okay, so coming back to rule number three. So I specifically mentioned like you need to have an open mind in the market. Have an open mind and try to understand what the market is saying. Okay, so here, if you are just fixed on this head and shoulders pattern, you would have missed this great opportunity to make 500, 600 points profit Nifty, right? But if you are open to the market, you would have understood, yes, Nifty is forming a triple bottom, and the triple bottom low is broken. So it is a very good entry point for me. It is a very good time for me to short the market. We shorted the market as soon as the low is broken out, and we kept the target at 13,650, and we made huge profits over here in Nifty. So this is how you need to trade in market. This is how you need to be open in the market. As I said, market always gives an indication before going in a particular direction. You need to catch that indication and you need to enter into the trade before it's too late. Okay. So coming back to budget 2020, why Nifty was so bullish during budget 2020. So the first one, give me a minute. Yeah. So the first rule, when there is a huge fall in the market, see, from 14,750, Nifty came all the way down to 13,600. So that's almost like 1,100 points. So market fell 1,100 points without giving a proper correction. So when there is a huge fall, it is expected that the market should give a proper correction. Now, in this particular sense, Nifty is in a perfect uptrend. It's in a perfect bullish market. So this particular 1,100 points, this is the correction. So from here, Nifty will start continue to go up. It will continue its upward direction. So this is your first indication that Nifty is going to reverse. And your second indication is, Nifty has already given my triple bottom target. So this is your entry price over here, and the target for triple bottom is 13,650. So Nifty came all the way down to 13,600. So your triple bottom target is also done, and from here Nifty has to start moving up. And the third indication is there is a very strong support at 13,550 to 13,600 levels. So once Nifty breaks this 13,550 levels, it's down direction for almost like 300, 400 points. There's no stopping Nifty in between that. So over here, Nifty fell all the way down to 13,600, and we predicted that the 13,650 trend line will not get broken out. Sorry, 13,650 support line will not get broken out. So Nifty closed just above the support. So this is a clear indication that February 1st would be a bullish day. So this is your third indication. And your fourth indication is your RSI divergence. Just correlate Nifty chart with your RSI divergence. See, RSI from the top, Nifty is also at the top. Nifty is falling, your RSI is falling. Came all the way down to 13 or 14. See over here, it came all the way down to 14. And from here, it gave a small correction. Your RSI is increasing, and here you can see the RSI divergence. See, RSI didn't make a lower low. It formed a higher low. So this is a clear indication that Nifty is going to move up. So this is your fourth indication for budget 2020 that Nifty is going to be bullish. And your fifth indication, and the most important indication among this all, is Nifty is in an uptrend market, and this is a correction that's given in Nifty, and Nifty is exactly at the golden Fibonacci ratio of 0.618. So this is your fifth confirmation, and this is a very most important confirmation, because from the golden ratio, Nifty has no choice but to move up. So this is your fifth confirmation. Okay, so when all these confirmations show a particular output, like Nifty has already reached its downtrend, it has already given a proper amount of correction, and Nifty has already given a signal that I'm going to move up from February, you don't have to have any fear in taking a trade. Okay, so this is exactly why we gave this is our premium channel. So this is January 31st. And we told in our premium channel, like, for February 1st, volatility will be very high, expecting 500,000 points movement. We did not analyze the Nifty chart back then, so we just gave general observation, like Nifty will be moving by 500,000 points. And this is February 1st. This is a budget day. And over on the budget day, we said the clear direction, like market has already filled by 1,000 points from last week, and we are bullish on the budget based on our technical analysis. And the most important thing is, let's take this as an opportunity, right? See, market will not move by 600, 700 points in a single day so easily. It happens every once in a year. So when that happens, when you have proper technical, when you have already done your proper technical analysis, and when you know Nifty is going to move up, you shouldn't miss trades like that. You should be confident to enter into the particular trade and come out with huge profits. So let me just have a show you a glimpse of the call that we took on February 1st. So this is Bank Nifty 32,500 CE. So this particular call was ported on 11:28 a.m. So all our members entered this particular call at 140 levels. And as you know, Bank Nifty 32,500 CE went all the way up to 2,195 to be precise. That's almost like a whooping 16 times profit. And best of all, your maximum risk is only 3,500, and your reward is 50,000, 50,000, 55,000, somewhere around that. So this particular trade happens once or twice in a month. And when this particular trade happens, when all these particular criteria aligns, you need to do a proper technical analysis like this, what we have done over here. And you need to be confident in your technical analysis and predict. So we told, like, we are bullish on budget 2020, and we entered a trade based on analysis, and it gave us 16 times a profit, right? So bottom line to all this is proper technical analysis. Market will always give a proper indication before going in a particular direction, right? So I hope everyone enjoyed this video, and I hope this clarifies your doubts about the budget 2020 movement. Sorry, budget 2021 movement. So if you have any questions, you can just give a comment below the video section. And if you find this video useful, you can just give it a like, and you can just share it to your friends. Okay, I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care. Bye bye.